Hi and welcome back to the Event Lighting channel. Today we're going to talk about GrandMA3 and RDM. RDM, or Remote Device Management, is a standard which is across many different lighting consoles and lighting fixtures, and it's basically a two-way communication with a fixture in your rig, and it goes through your DMX cable. So it's very helpful if somebody made a mistake. Maybe your riggers put up a lot of fixtures, and then when everything up and all the trusses are ready, you figure out that there's a problem with a DMX address. Maybe one of your fixtures is in a wrong mode, or there can be other things you can do via the RDM protocol. So today's video, I'm going to show you how it works, how you configure your console to utilize RDM, and what benefits it has on your lighting fixtures and stuff like that. So welcome to this video. Let's get right into it. So as you can see here in the background, I have three lighting fixtures just not doing anything right now. And if I go into my patch, you can see here that the ones we are talking about is our house wash 1, 2, and 3. And I did a little cheating here because one of them is an Aura XIP. Another one is a Luma 700 from ProLight. And the last one is a Diamond 7 from ProLight. You can see here that the XIP is supposed to be in basic mode and the other two is supposed to be in standard mode. And the addresses is the XIP is supposed to be 101, the Luma 700 is supposed to be 201, and the Diamond 7 is supposed to be 301. But as you can see, they are all addressed number one. And as you also can see, if we zoom in here a little bit, you can see that they're also in wrong modes. So what we can do now, we have two choices basically. We can ask one of the lighting riggers to climb up into the truss and fix it up there, or we can try to help him and fix it from the console if it's possible. RDM works straight out of any GrandMA3 interface, that means out of the console, out of a node, out of a processing unit. But you have to be careful that your splitters, if you're using DMX splitters, has to be RDM compatible, otherwise the communication is broken. What you can do is take the DMX line out, put it straight into the console up to the fixtures, and then you can temporarily set your RDM commands, and then you can connect it back into the splitter if you have that problem. So let's try to set this stuff up with RDM, and the first thing you want to do, of course, is to connect this 5-pin connector in your console, and then you want to connect it straight into the first moving light. In this case we have three, and you can then daisy chain the other ones so everything is connected on the same line. When we've done that, we are basically ready to implement our RDM, and there is a few different ways you can set up RDM in your console. The first thing you have to do is to go into your connector configuration right here, and then you can see all our connections. And we connected our DMX line into our console, DMX line number one. So we have to set the DMX line number one up to be an RDM output. So what we do is we find our output wherever you are connected, you right click on it, and here where it says out, you can simply go down and set it into RDM. And then you apply that and you can see it changes color, and that means it's now an RDM output. But it doesn't work yet because we have to turn RDM on globally on the entire console. And there's a few different ways we can do that. In our connector configuration here, you have an RDM button down here. And if you have multiple RDM outputs set up, this will activate all of them. But this is one of the places. Another place is in our network. There's also an RDM switch down here. And the last place is basically in our live patch. You can see down here we have RDM and you can activate it down here. So if we activated it in our live patch, it's basically the easiest way. You get the information up here on the screen. But let me just show you, if you want an RDM output in one of your windows, you can clear your screen. You can make a new window here and you can go into tools and you have your RDM device viewer here as well. But let's do this from the live patch. We go into the RDM window here and we activate RDM. And RDM sometimes it takes a little while before it pops up. You can see now something popped up. You can see it found two devices. Now it's found three devices here in our window. we can click this little arrow here, and it identifies the fixtures that are RDM compatible on the DMX line right now. And as you can see here, we have a lot of different options. You can see the DMX address, they are all set to 1, which is the same as we see over here. And we have the DMX personalities selected here, and they are all wrong. We need to fix all of them. So the first thing we want to do, if we look at our fixtures over here, the display is upside down. So let's just fix that, and we can do that via the RDM commands. We can go into display invert, we can right click, and we can set it to off, and that should flip the displays so they now face the right way, so we can start working and maybe see a little better what's going on. Another cool feature you can do with RDM is to ask a fixture to identify itself. Let's say you have a lot of the same type of fixtures with the wrong addresses or the wrong modes. You want to make sure you're working with the right one. And you can do that here with identify. You can see it up here on the screen. So if I go into my Luma 700, for instance, and set it to identify, it's going to take a few seconds, and you can see it's now flashing here in the background. And the fixtures will do different things depending on the manufacturer, I guess. So if you go into the XIP here and you ask that one to identify itself, it's gonna flip around and turn on and off and stuff like that. So it's not the same thing they're doing, it doesn't really matter. It's just gonna identify itself and do something funny up there so you can see which one you're working with. The next thing we can do is we can see the DMX personality here. If we zoom into the fixtures, they are not in the right mode. You can see here on the Luma 700, it's in extended mode, and we want it in standard mode, and we want to change the address. So the first thing we want to do after we set the display to invert on is go into our XIP down here. RDM fixture 3 is our XIP. We can right click, and it tells you what options you have on the personality side. So we want to set it into our basic DMX mode here. And then you can see it actually switches mode and uses less channels. The next one we have from the Luma 700 from ProLight, we right click and we set it into standard, and that would put it into standard mode right away. And the last one here, the Diamond 7, we also put into standard mode like this. So now we corrected the wrong modes, and now we need to set the correct addresses. So as you can see, the fixtures are on in our 3D because we have patched them in our 3D and we have placed them in our 3D environment. But now we need to make sure they work. And I know that the XIP is supposed to have an address of 101. So if we right click and we set it to 101, you will pretty quickly see it's gonna change over here and start working the way it's supposed to. We can take the Luma 700 and we can call it 201 because that's the address we want that one to have. And it takes a few seconds sometime with the RDM. It's not the fastest protocol, but as you can see, it woke up and got its right address. And the last one, the Luma 700, we patch at 301, and that would wake that one up in a second, and we are now ready to go. So that's the power of RDM. There's a few things you have to be careful with on RDM or using RDM. RDM is really, really cool when you need it, and you can activate it when you need it, but remember to deactivate it when you don't need it, because RDM can make some noise on your DMX lines. They can flip out or do something weird or start to flicker or something like that because of the RDM protocol when it's active. So what you do when you have fixed your rig, you go in and you turn off RDM here on the global output, and I will always go into my connector configuration here and set my output to output again and not to be RDM. So that's RDM on GrandMA3. I hope you enjoyed this small short tutorial on RDM, and if you like the video, make sure to give it a like. That's gonna help the video be pushed out to more people on YouTube. And if you enjoy the content here on the Event Lighting channel, make sure you subscribe so you get notified if you click the little bell icon every time I upload a new video. Until I see you next time, have some happy GrandMA3 programming moments at home, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.